Welcome students, hope you're all doing good. So before we move on to today's class, we'll have a recap of what we learned in the previous class, okay? So first we looked into the framing algebraic statements. In framing algebraic statements, we saw how to convert algebraic statements to verbal statements, how to convert verbal statements to algebraic statements, and then we moved on to solving unknown through examples. At last, we solved problems related to framing algebraic statements. Okay, so in today's class you'll be learning about patterns and we'll be solving miscellaneous problems. Okay, so we already saw what are patterns. So what are patterns? It allows us to make reasonable guesses, and understanding patterns provides a clear basis for problem solving skills. Okay, so patterns allows us to make reasonable guesses and it provides a clear basis for problem solving skills. So now we look into an example. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10, and the number goes on. Okay, so in this we observe that 1 is odd, 2 is even, 3 is odd, 4 is even, etc. Thus odd numbers and even numbers are alternate with each other. Okay, so if I tell you that I have a sequence 16, 12, 8, 4, okay, can you find the next number? It's very easy, right? Each number is obtained by subtracting 4 from the previous number. So when you subtract 12 from 16, you get the answer 4. Similarly, when you subtract 8 from 12, the answer you get is 4. When you subtract 4 from 8 also, the answer you get is 4, right? So what will be the next number? Yes, the fourth number will be 0. So yes, when you subtract 0 from 4, the answer you get is 4, okay? So the fourth number is 0. So now we'll be moving to the problems. Okay, now we'll be solving exercise number 2.2, that is we'll be solving the miscellaneous problems in today's class. Okay, so the first sum is complete the following pattern. What comes next? So the first pattern is 9 minus 7, so the answer you get is 8. So the next pattern is 98 minus 21. So when you subtract 21 from 98, the answer you get is 77. Okay. And the third pattern is 987 minus 321. So when you subtract 321 from 987, the answer you get is 666. From these three patterns you can observe that the second one is written as 9 and the number before 9. Okay, so 98 minus the number after 1 is 2, right? So 21. So when you subtract 21 from 98, the answer you get is 77. Similarly, the third pattern is obtained by 98 and the number before 8, that is 7, followed by the number after 2 is 3. So it is written as 321. And the answer you get is 666. The fourth pattern is 9876 minus 4321. So when you subtract 4321 from 9876, the answer you get is 5555. Okay. So in this pattern, you can observe that the number 6 is obtained by the number before 7, that is 987, and the number before 7 is 6, so 9876. Whereas in the second number, the number after 3 is written, okay, so 4326. Got it, students? So when you subtract 4321 from 9876, the answer you get is 5555. Okay, and the next pattern is 98,765 minus 54,321. So when you subtract 54,321 from 98,765, the answer you get is 44,444. Okay, so this pattern is written as 9876 from the above step, and the number before 6 is written, that is 5. Okay, similarly 431 is written, and before 4 the number written is 5, that is the number after 4 is written before 4. Okay, So the answer you get is 44,444. Now you are going to find the next pattern. So what will be the next pattern? Yes, it is 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. And what will be the next number? Yes, 4 minus the number after 5. That is 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So when you subtract 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 from 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, the answer you get is 333333. Okay, so the answer you get is 333,333. Got it, students? So this is the answer for the first sum. Okay, now we'll move to the second sum. A piece of wire is 12 s centimeter long. What will be the length of the side if it's formed as first one is equilateral triangle and second one is a square? So what are you supposed to find in this question? The length of the side of equilateral triangle and a square. Okay, so first we'll find out equilateral triangle. So what is given in the question? The length of a piece of wire is 12 s centimeter long. Okay, so an equilateral triangle has three equal sides. So this is the picture of an equilateral triangle. So an equilateral triangle has three equal sides. So you are going to find out the length of the sides. Okay, so in order to find the length of the side of an equilateral triangle, you are going to divide 12s by 3. So when you divide 12 by 3, the answer you get is 4. Okay, so the answer will be 4. Yes, so in the question, the length of a piece of wire is given. So you are going to divide the 12s by 3. Okay, so when you divide 12 by 3, the answer you get is 4s. So therefore, the length of the side of an equilateral triangle is 4s. Got it, students? Now we'll move on to the square. So the length of the piece of wire is 12s. Okay, so that is what given in the question, right? So a square has four equal sides. So from the picture, you could see that a square has four equal sides. Okay, so in order to find out the length of the side of a square, you are going to divide 12s by 4. Okay, since square has four equal sides, you are going to divide the value of 12s by 4. So when you divide 12 by 4, the answer you get is 3s. So the length of the side of a square is 3s. Got it, students? Whereas the length of the side of an equilateral triangle is 4s and the length of the side of a square is 3s. Okay, since equilateral triangle has three equal sides, you are going to divide the value 12s by 3. Okay, whereas here square has four equal sides, so you are going to divide the value 12s by 4. Got it, students? So now we'll move on to the third sum. Identify the value of the shapes and figures in the table given below and verify their addition horizontally and vertically. Okay,
so this is the tabulation given. So you have to find the values of the shapes and figures. Okay, so the table consists of rows and columns. Rows are nothing but the horizontal table and columns are nothing but the vertical tables. Okay, so when you add all the values of the stars in the first column, the answer you get is 32. Okay, similarly, when you add the first row, the answer you get is 30. And when you add the second row, the answer you get is 36. Okay, so now you are going to find out the remaining values for the rows and columns. Okay, so from the first column, we can see that when we add four stars, the answer we get is 32. So what will be the value of one star? It is 8, right? So when you add 8 plus 8 plus 8 plus 8, the answer you get is 32. So the value of star must be 32. Okay, so we'll take the first row now. So the value of star is 8, right? Now the first row consists of two stars. Okay, so 8 plus 8 we get 16, right? But the value of the first row is 30. So when we subtract 16 from 30, the remaining answer is 14. The 14 is being split into two values because there are two smiley faces in the first row. Okay, so when we split 14 equally into two halves means the answer we get is 7, right? So 7 plus 7 is 14. So when we add 8 plus 7 plus 7 plus 8, the answer we get is 30. Okay, that is the first row. Now we'll move on to the second row. That is, we already know that the value of a star is 8. So there are two stars in the second row. So 8 plus 8 is 16. But the value of the second row is 36. So when we subtract 16 from 36, the answer we get is 20. So now we must divide the value 20 into two equal halves, since there are two triangles over here. So when we divide the value 20 into 2 equal half means we'll get the value 10. So 10 plus 10 is 20. So when we add the second row, it is 8 plus 8, that is 16. 16 plus 10 is 26, and 26 plus 10 is 36. So we get the answer 36 in the second row. So from this we observe that the value of a star is 8, the value of a smiley is 7, and the value of a triangle is 10. From this we can find out the value of the third row, that is star plus triangle plus two smiley faces. So the 8 plus 10 plus 7 plus 7. So the answer you get is 32. Okay, so from the third column you can see that the answer you get is 32. Okay, and next we'll move on to the fourth row, that is star plus smiley plus triangle plus smiley. So the answer you get when you add 8 plus 7 plus 10 plus 7 is 32. Okay, so now you are going to add the values of the columns. Okay, so already in the question the value of the first column is given, that is 32. Now you are going to find out the value of the second column, that is 7 plus 8 plus 10 plus 7, that is 32. Okay, and now we'll move on to the third column, that is 7 plus 10 plus 7 plus 10, which is 34. Okay, and when moving to the fourth column, 8 plus 10 plus 7 plus 7, we get 32. So rows are nothing but the horizontal table and columns are nothing but the vertical table. Okay, be clear in that, students. Okay, only then you can solve this problem easily. So when you add all these values, that is 30 plus 36 plus 32 plus 32, the answer you get is 130. Okay, similarly when you add the values of the last row, that is 32 plus 32 plus 34 plus 32, the answer you get is 130. So from this we can conclude that the assumption of our values are correct. Okay, understood, students? Now I'll move to the last sum. That is, the table given below shows the results of the matches played by 8 teams in a kabaddi. Okay, kabaddi championship tournament. Now this is the tabulation given. Now you are supposed to find out the value of all the variables in the table given above. Okay, so you could see that from the table there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there are totally 8 teams named as A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Okay, and each team has won and lost the matches. Okay, now you are supposed to find out the values of the variables. Okay, so in the A team, they have totally played 8 matches. Okay, so in that 8 matches, they have lost K matches and 1-5 matches. That is, you are going to find out the value of the lost match. Similarly, in the B team, they have played totally 7 matches and they have won 6 matches. So you are going to find out the remaining matches lost. Followed by C team, they have won 4 matches and they have lost 6 matches, and you are supposed to find out the total matches played. Okay, and the D team is the same as C team, they have won 7 matches and they have lost 2 matches, and you are going to find out the total matches played. Okay, and in E team, the total matches played is given and the number of matches lost is given, and you are going to find out the number of matches won. Okay, and in the F team, the same, total matches played is given, and here the matches the F team one has given, okay, and you are supposed to find out the total matches lost. Whereas in G team, the total matches played has given and the total matches lost is given. So you are going to find out the matches won, and in H team, the matches won and lost are given and you are going to find out the total matches played. Okay, so this is the question. So first we'll take the A team. So they have totally played 8 matches. So in that 8 matches, they have won 5 matches. Okay, so what is the remaining matches lost? So when you subtract 5 from 8, the answer you get is 3. Likewise, moving to the B team, they have played totally 7 matches, and in that 6 matches they have won. So the remaining matches lost is, when you subtract 6 from 7, the answer you get is 1. Okay, now we move to the C team. They have totally won 4 matches and they have totally lost 6 matches. Okay, so you are going to find out the total number of matches played by them. So you are supposed to add the number of matches won and number of matches lost. Okay, so when you add 4 and 6, the total number of matches played by the C team, that is 10. Okay, and now moving to the D team, similarly, they have won 7 matches and they have lost 2 matches. And now you are going to find out the total number of matches played. So in order to find the total number of matches played, you are going to add the number of matches won and number of matches lost. Okay, so when you add 7 and 2, the answer you get is 9. So now moving to the E team, they have totally played 9 matches and in that 3 matches they have lost. Now you are supposed to find out the number of matches won. So when you subtract 3 from 9, the answer you get is 6. Okay, have this trick in your mind, students. If you want to find out the number of matches won or lost, you are supposed to subtract. Okay, if you want to find out the number of matches played, that is the total number of matches played by that team, means you are going to add the matches won and matches lost. Okay, so now moving to the F team, they have totally played 10 matches and in that 6 matches they have won. So you are going to find out the number of matches lost. So you will be subtracting 6 from 10 and the answer you get is 4. Okay, and now moving to the G team, so they have totally played 8 matches and in that 4 matches they have lost. So you are going to find out the number of matches won. So in order to find out the number of matches won or lost, what are you supposed to find? You are going to subtract, right? So you are going to subtract 4 from 8. So when you subtract, the answer you get is 4, okay? And the last team is the H team. And you are supposed to find out the total number of matches played here, and the number of matches the H team has won is 3 and the number of matches they lost is 6. So when you add 3 and 6, you'll find the answer for the total number of matches played, that is 9. Okay, so it's very simple, students. When you want to find out the total number of matches played, you are going to add the values of matches won and matches lost. Okay, but if you want to find out the value of the matches won or lost, means you are going to subtract the value. Okay, got it, students? So that's it for today's class, students. We have completed the second chapter, that is Introduction to Algebra. From next class, we'll be learning about the third chapter, that is Ratios and Proportions. Okay, now I'll do a small recap of what we have learned in today's class. Okay.
So first we looked into what are patterns. So what are patterns? Patterns allows us to make reasonable guesses, and understanding patterns provides a clear basis for problem solving skills. Okay, and then we saw the examples of patterns, and next we moved on to the miscellaneous problems in your textbooks. Okay, we solved 4 miscellaneous problems from your textbook. Okay. So now it's time for question and answer. So what are patterns? Patterns allows us to make reasonable guesses. Yes, very good. So understanding patterns provides a clear basis for problem solving skills. Excellent. So that's it, students. We have completed the second chapter, that is Introduction to Algebra. From next class, we will be learning about the third chapter, that is Ratios and Proportions. Okay. Now I have attached the worksheets for you. Kindly solve it in your rough notebook. Thank you, students.